Question 27. The best answer is A. Because the author states in lines 39 to 41 that although Holman and a colleague published the idea in 2005, astronomers failed to detect transit timing variations because almost all known exoplanets were gas giants spinning around their stars in tight orbits, which meant that such planets formed farther from the star and later barreled inward, clearing away any potential wobble-inducing companions. Only after Kepler spacecraft, the TTV was easy to implement. The technique became practical thanks to the Kepler spacecraft. Kepler began delivering data on dozens of planetary systems, many of them consisting of multiple planets. In 2010, astronomers began making TTV detections. Hence, it can be inferred that it was because of Kepler spacecraft that TTV was possible to be used. The main difficulty in implementing the TTV technique was because TTV required the existence of companion planets, and most known exoplanets prior to Kepler did not show evidence of companions. Choices B, C, and D are incorrect because according to the passage, the TTV technique was difficult to implement before the data from the Kepler spacecraft became available because TTV required the existence of companion planets, not because TTV required several different sets of data for confirmation and prior to Kepler only a single set of data was available. Not because it required that a planet orbit a parent star, and prior to Kepler the location of the parent stars of exoplanets was difficult to determine. And not because it required that the mass of a planet be known, and prior to Kepler the masses of exoplanets were impossible to ascertain.